Hey guys, I'm Emily from the Blue Mouse, and today I'm going to show you how to work German short rows. So I'm going to show you how to do this working a project in the round, but the concept is the same whether you are working in the round or flat. So you're just going to go ahead and work in pattern until you get to the place where you want to make your first turn. So when you're ready to make your first turn, you've got your yarn in the back and you're just going to turn your work. So go ahead and flip it around. And the important thing to note is that you always want to have your yarn in the front. So if your yarn is in the back, go ahead and bring it in between your needles to the front. That is the same whether you're working a wrong side row or a right side row. No matter when you're working this, you always want to have your yarn in front. So to work this, you're going to go ahead and go into the first stitch on your left-hand needle as if to purl. So go ahead and go into it and slip it to your right-hand needle. And then you're going to take your yarn and go up and over that right hand needle. So go over it, around to the back, and you should be able to see two strands now. So it looks like two stitches, but that is just the same stitch pulled over. And that is why it's called a double stitch. And so now I'm going to pull on it just a little bit so that it pulls just a little bit tight. You don't want to go crazy with it, but just pull it so that the tension is normal, like a normal stitch. And since I'm working in stockinette, I need to purl back along this side. So I go ahead and bring my yarn in between my needles to the front and purl back. And then you just continue until you're ready to make your next turn. All right, when you come to the place where you're ready to turn on a wrong side row, do the same thing. Just go ahead and turn your work. And like I said before, you always want your yarn to be in front when you're making a double stitch. So my yarn is in the back. I'm going to bring it between my needles to the front. So now we're going to go into the first stitch on your left-hand needle and slip it as if to purl. So go into it as if to purl, but just slip it. And now we're going to bring the yarn up and over around to the back. So just go ahead and pull on it to get a correct tension, and you'll see that you have two strands here, and that makes that double stitch. And so now I'm just going to continue in my pattern, which for this is just knitting. So here's my double stitch. I just keep going. And you'll see it there. It looks like a double stitch. And they're kind of twisted over each other. A lot of patterns will tell you to work in pattern or knit until you get to a certain amount of stitches before the last double stitch. So here's my double stitch. And you can see it just looks a little bit funky compared to the other stitches. So it's these two right here, right there. So if I were to knit to say five stitches before that, here's my double stitch and I count five. So just two, four, and five. And then this is where I would make my turn. So here I have come to my double stitch for my last row. You can see it here, it kind of looks different than a normal stitch. You can tell by the front of it. So most of your patterns will have you knit them as a single stitch or work them as a single stitch. So it's really easy. You're just going to knit these two strands together. So you're just going to go into this double stitch like a normal stitch and just knit it. And I like to correct my tension a little bit after I have knit it and then just keep going. And the wonderful thing about German short rows is that they're pretty invisible. So you can kind of see it, but not really, which is nice. You can see it on the wrong side, but on the right side, it's pretty invisible. All right, so now let's say that you need to work a double stitch from the purl side or the wrong side. You can see my double stitch is here. It's kind of twisted over itself. This is the same concept as before. We're just going to go into this stitch as if to purl and then just purl it. And tug on it just a little bit to return it to normal tension. You can kind of see it from the wrong side, but it's right there on the right side, and you can't even tell. Thank you for watching, guys. Please like and subscribe for more videos. I also do a weekly knitting podcast. If you're interested in that, I'll link it below.